All right, so we'll move on in the interest of time, but we won't rush you, JD, so move forward. Go ahead, you're on.
This is a case regarding a tree zoning. US 84 I-75 Industrial Park. In this case, we do zone back in 2010. It increased split zone, as you see here, M2, M1, and PD. Was originally requested to do an IS zoning at that time in northwest corner, which you see here in the lighter gray. Since then, parts of this property have been sold off, sitting out the phase portion that was requested IS in that northwest corner for the railway water treatment facility here. This request is to allow solar use within FPD. We have the history up there in your staff report. I'll give you the brief. Staff has reviewed this request and concluded that a solar panel array such as this proposed from the original approved site plan proposed here. It is not allowed in the PD zoning district. PD is intended for projects that include interrelated residential, commercial, and office uses unified by a development plan. Solar panel array is not consistent with this intent. Services zoning, IS, specifically allows for, and I'm quoting, private facilities for energy generation, which may require environmental permits. The current site plan approved in 2010 is binding on all future use and development, and a PD amendment requires a new fully compliant site plan. Staff has not been presented with a new fully compliant PD site plan. In addition, a solar panel array does not fit within new M1 or M2 zonings, as M1 districts are intended for warehousing, assembly, storage, and commercial services, while M2 districts are for manufacturing, assembly, storage, distribution, and sales activities that are generally high intensity. Staff is supportive of the solar panel array on the property. The question is how to achieve this use consistent with the current ULDC standards. If the application was withdrawn and resubmitted to rezone the property to IS, staff would find the request consistent with the intended use of the property.
So at the top of this map here, they're going to leave access to this parcel. Solar array will be down here.
Correct. Approximately, and I'm going back to the approved site plan, buildings E, F, and potentially G, but primarily E and F, where the proposed solar array extends from east to west through the M1 and M2 zones.
So just for clarification, the applicant would be the only one to make that request, could be the only one to make that request.
For the IS zoning?
Right. Could we not offer any alternative suggestions, I guess is my point.
We could offer those suggestions for the commission to consider, but as it's presented right now, it is just for the
to lock them in and being approved and know what they're going
to do. Right. I mean, does that work? I don't know what the protocol here is, JD. Is the applicant, could he change it now? Or does this have to go back through the application process?
I do not believe they could change it midstream as it has been advertised as, so that it shall be heard as amended to. Portion and now it's included in more than two site plans.
All right, so as it stands, you're recommending denial and it does not fit.
I'm recommending that we're examining the IS.
Okay, gotcha. I understand.
Point of clarification, if we deny this, does that put a restraint on the applicant? applicant and when he can appeal?
Yes, 12 months.
12 months.
12 months.
That's not. Withdraw. I would suggest we table it.
Why don't we let them speak?
Okay, all right, well, let's do that then. So we'll open this up to those who wish to speak on behalf of this request, so you can probably answer some questions, Jack.
All right, thank you. Jack Langdale, 701 North Patterson. I want to talk a little bit about this site. It was rezoned about 10 years ago, instead of 2010.
Right.
Remember, it didn't that long ago, I guess it was. And it's for M1, M2, and PD, most of the neighborhood. And over that period of time, we have had opportunities to sell this property in the zoning classifications for intensive uses. And we made the decision, this came up, that it wasn't the right thing to do because of the potential for sound and other for neighbors. So we've been sitting back, have done intentions since that time. Now, recently, we've gotten this opportunity with solar. And solar, we thought would be perfect to be that close to a residential. There's a large barn constructed, so you can't see it. Solar panels, no odor, they don't make any sound, but it just seemed like a perfect fit right there. And I don't think anyone is objecting to solar panels built there, so I don't need to make it about whether the planners want a solar panel. The question is whether a solar panel is allowed in PD. That is a good question. I understand what planning is struggling with. Recall, the term solar panel is not mentioned anywhere in the ULDC. This is happening all over South Florida, probably all over the state.
Prior to what?
Solar projects weren't a thing until recently. So these land development ordinances weren't drafted contemplating where is a solar panel. But I wanted to point out a couple things. An essential public service is allowed in all zoning classifications except for MAZ. So if solar panels are considered an essential public service, then they are allowed in PD, they are allowed in M1, and they are allowed in M2. So if anywhere out there, the request that we're making is only to amend the site plan to allow solar panels. We're not asking to change any other uses. We just want to amend it to allow solar panels. So if solar panels are considered an essential public service, then we shouldn't have any trouble. So there's not a whole lot in the ULDC about essential public services. It does say there's public, of course, that's in the name. And it gives the example of transmission lines. Transmission lines are essential public service. So keep that in mind, so keep going. That is the best example. It also puts the example of a lift station being an essential public service. The transmission lines we're not going to get back to. If it is not an essential public service, and one interpretation could be, and it's the county's interpretation, which is a great one, so I understand we can have different interpretations. The county's interpretation is that it most likely would be a better fit for intensive services. Intensive services, IS, that is a much more robust zoning classification. Lots of things that can be done there that you would not want to see. For example, landfills, wastewater treatment facilities, and what the county attorney is grabbing on is energy generation. Now, to me, energy generation means a power plant, not solar. And if you look in the ULDC as to what you have to give to the county when evaluating, an intensive service, and this is just directly out of the ULDC. This is what, if I'm petitioning for an intensive service, this is what the county wants to know. They want to know about the EPD, they want to know about minerals and byproducts and waste, they want to know what kind of noise, odor, water quality, smoke and particulate matter, noxious fumes, vibrations, hazardous materials, corrosive, explosive, toxic, radiation, lighting, that all of these questions, to me, sounds like they're contemplating power. And a power plant, you think about large amounts of fuel driving electrical turbines, large amounts of water, air emissions, all of these things, if you read what they're talking about, IS, all of these things sound like a power plant. Now, a solar panel is sitting out there in a field, it's not making any noise. There are no emissions, there are no particular permits required, EPD is not involved. None of these things are applicable to a solar panel. A solar panel is just a solar cell sitting out in the middle of this field, capturing the sun's energy and putting it on the grid. So, I don't know, to me, a solar panel capturing the sun's energy sounds a heck of a lot more like a transmission line than it does anything contemplated in intensive services. So, another thing that I think is very important, let's look at the precedent for solar panels in Lowndes County. If you look around, you see them all over the place. There's one on 376. That zone classification is R1, residential. As far away from intensive services as you can get. Then look at the one out on Hunt Road. That zone classification is RA, which, of course, far from intensive services. The only way that I can see that you could approve a solar panel on either of those two sites is if you consider them essential public services. So I'm making an assumption that that's what they did because I can't see any other way justify a solar panel on residential authority. If you don't classify it as essential public service, because essential public service is allowed anyway. But we make the argument that solar panels are much more like a transmission line than they are a power plant. And we think that the only way that they could have been approved in R1 and RA before is if the county is already considering essential public service. We would just like to see that classification held here. We'd like to see this board and county commissioners say that they agree with our interpretation that essential public service is what a solar panel is more likely. You know, there's no black and white answer to this. It's just which gray area is it more close to. And the thing is, we don't want to rezone this to IS. We don't want to see IS sign go up and start the subdivision. And I know that we could clarify that certain IS uses aren't allowed, but you know, like people live out there, don't always see it that way. I guarantee you have a room full of people who are asking for intensive service rezoning versus just modifying the PD to allow solar power. We think that the essential public service would have to be the way it's classified before on the other solar projects. We think solar panels a lot more like a transmission line than it is in these intensive services.
Thank you very much. Y'all have questions for Mr. Lincoln? Thank you. All right. Any questions? So that exhausted our time for those wishing to speak on behalf. Is there anyone here this evening wishing to speak against this request? Please come forward.
Hi, Ken Smith, 2719 Scott Street. I would speak against the original proposal, M1 to M2 and the PD to M1. I don't have a problem with the solar panels. I think that's fine. I would prefer what the gentleman was saying, that it be accommodated as an essential service under the existing zoning. I'm some of the same concerns I have with the original proposal. I have the IS proposal. So, I live in that community, and over in that M2, there's a glass factory that creates a lot of noise. That has been a problem and a nuisance in that neighborhood. And I'm just concerned about the encroachment of heavy industry or other potential nuisance activities closer and closer to the neighborhood.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Smith. Is there anyone else here tonight who wishes to speak against this request? Come forward.
William Cole, KLLP, 2727 Scott Street. I too have some more concerns and concerns are noise, light pollution, etc. Originally, when this area was rezoned 12 years ago, there's a lot of talk about effects on community, of course, everybody was by the property no question. Aesthetics have this industrial brain and things like smell, etc. One of the things trees planted, shrubs planted, what we got is a pile of mud full of erosion. And our resident part of it, the other part of it, things go all down the properties. Scott Street, Mr. Smith, works on just Thomas Street over there. While they aesthetics, it's an eyesore. Property that we've done at the same time, had not grown up.
So we'll close out the public hearing portion of that, and we'll turn it back over to the commissioners for any other discussion. Any questions, discussion?
I just have a quick question from that. The solar array that we approved on South 41, that was in M1 or M2? Is that correct?
It's M1 zone, and but in the city limits.
Okay. All right. If there's no other discussion, I'll ask for a motion.
Madam Chairman,
Mr. Miles.
In this case, I reviewed the complaint as well, where the applicant is seeking to amend a PD portion of this site for solar panels. I'd like to make a motion that we recommend. to be an essential public service. And I find that it's really in keeping with a wide sweeping tendency around the world to reduce the carbon footprint, businesses and general, and living in general. And I think that this, toward this end, this is something that we're all going to be having to look at and looking toward implementing if we are going to be successful in making any kind of an impact on carbon reduction. So that's my rationale for support.
All right. Okay.
Do
you
want
to so we have that motion by Commissioner Wallace to approve, seconded by Commissioner Hightower. Any other discussion on that motion?
Madam Chair,
yes.
Request to approve and to interpret solar panels
as an essential public service.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. All right. All those in favor of the motion to approve, please raise your right hand. All those against, and the motion carries. Okay. Yes. REZ 20.